I'm sorry for the regular technical delay that I get over Sofia Game Jam, as always. As many of you know me, I'm all about getting a lot of diversifiers and not a lot of the main teams. So hopefully, after a while, we can see our game. So first of all, I would like to say that this is our team portrait, hence the name over there. It's the Rover and his wife, you know, like the farmer and his wife, and this is actually the classical painting. This is where the name comes from, by the way. And our game is called 30 Seconds to MarZ. There is a backstory, but really what we try to do here is make, and this was my intention all along when I was coming to Sofia Game Jam this week, to make a 30-second game so that it's as engaging as possible, but at the same time it is playable. As you said, it's an important thing. So I have made our game. Actually, it's a team effort, by the way. Somewhere here is my beautiful wife and the art director of our team, Michaela. Where are you? And she did the art. And basically the game is as follows. I don't know why we don't have sound, by the way. Sound. Driving, okay. Anyway, the sound is beautiful and but thanks, this time it is a free one. Yeah, it's not something that somebody can compose. And by the way, what is the game about? We have... okay, very quick. We have... basically, three things to take that are important. There is an emitter, a transmitter that has to transmit a signal towards a rover in MarZ, our friend opportunity on MarZ. And there is only one way to direct this signal is by reflecting through our system of satellites. And there are many obstacles that we have to overcome. By the way, within the obstacle there is an Easter egg as well. So I'm going to start it. And what I can do here is basically only this. And I have to direct the signal packets up somehow to reach the opportunity rover. And I would like to tell you an advice, not all the games are winnable. Yeah, oops, I'm almost there. Anyway, in 30 seconds, the game is over, and when I restart, I actually end up in a different background, different music, different randomly generated configuration, and different situation all over, so that we can make it as playable as possible. And I can see some of the physics is still not working fine, but anyway, oops. You've probably seen me doing this crazy stuff in Scratch. Most of you know, most of you badass programmers said that I'm crazy to do this in a visual scripting language. And this morning, after a while not sleeping, I actually agree with you. What else? Actually, I would like to show you some of the diversifiers. Actually, we hit six here, but only four are acceptable to be registered. So first of all, we used the well-rounded art. Second of all, we used a mechanics that you don't actually manage the main character, but you somehow manage it through other obstacles or something like this. Then it's actually played under 30 seconds. I didn't know about this diversifier before that, but it's actually along my plan. Actually, there was a Easter egg. Actually, the game is very small, and actually it is drone for color impaired people. So it is contrast, and you can I have two other diversifiers here, and you can play it all online all the time. By the way, here is Mikhail and me. And yes, this is the game that I have prepared officially. But then again, I have made another game because there was another diversifier, which was making a game within the last hour of the Sofia game of the game jam. So yes, it is a rough game, but it's playable. Everything almost everything of it works. Let me see. Probably it's time for me to explain several things, basically about my life. Basically, I have grown in a very dark times, the early 90s, in very dark places. This is downtown Sofia. Basically, the radius, 300 meters radius of the most murders, the center of this circle was in my front yard. And I used to do and see a lot of dark people playing this game on trash cans over cardboard boxes. And by the way, this is another diversifier, by the way. So it's called Bank Antinari, and it is a gambling game. I am the bank, and you play against me, and you basically have two choices. You can bet on small or big, and then we toss two dice. And if the big come up, you win, and then you have, of course, bet on them. If not, I win, and that's it. Do you want to play a round of it or two?
Yes.
Okay. First of all, let's figure out what is the bet size, and you only have 10 levels. Don't ask me more than this because I don't have protection of my software. Okay? I haven't put any limitations yet. It's an hour under an hour game. So, what sort of bet size are we going to put?
All-in.
All-in. Okay. Let's make it all-in. Okay. So all-in. Right? And then, are we going to bet on smalls or on bigs?
Bigs.
Okay, bigs. If I have put small, it would be working. And then we're going to roll the dice, right?
Yeah.
Okay, you win. Thank you. So don't forget, and I'm going to leave this impression because this is what we're going to see during voting, is, you know, this wonderful art that my wife painted. Okay, thank you. And okay, there is somebody who wants to ask a question. Do we have this?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
What happens on the number 7?
Okay, well, there somewhere in the universe, a mousetrap just clicked. Because now you're in my lecture in risk management. And yes, there are three lessons here. First of all is...
I said we can have questions.
You can explain. So yes, there is every gambling game is not fair game. Okay, so on average you're a loser, if you're paying. Unless you're the bank, okay?
Thank you. Thank you. I think the moral of this story